Okay, so let's talk about how to solve another absolute value equation. If you want a little bit more background in how these kind of work, maybe watch one of the other videos that I have. But typically when it comes to absolute value equations, the main thing that you need to be aware of is the setup of the equation. Do you have an absolute value set equal to an absolute value? Do you have a greater than a number, less than a number, or is it an equal to? Because depending on how you're given the equation, that's going to depend on how you break up your equation. When it comes to absolute value equations, we always split our example into two different problems. The first problem is always our normal problem, the way that it looks as is. And the second problem, we always change it. So for this particular example, we have an absolute value set equal to an absolute value. And right up here, I have the rules that tells us how do we work this out. All right, so if we're solving an absolute value equals an absolute value, this is what we do. We solve two different equations. The first equation is what the normal equation looks like minus the absolute value bar. So literally just strip those bars away and solve that equation. The second equation here, so when it comes to absolute value equations, the second equation is always changed. If it has an inequality symbol, you flip it. If it's equal, that stays the same. So you normally change the symbol. We can't change an equal sign. Right, equal is always equal. If it's inequality, you flip it. And what you set it equal to, that's what changed. You always set it equal to the opposite of what you have. So change the sign of everything on the right-hand side of that equal sign. If it's just one single number, you change the sign for that one. If you have a couple more things going on inside of it, you need to take the opposite of the whole thing. So think about it as changing the sign of everything or as distributing the negative to everything there. So this is what that's gonna look like then. So splitting this up into two different equations. The first one is our normal one. 7x plus 12 is equal to x minus 8. Nothing changes there. The second equation will be 7x plus 12, that always stays the same on the left-hand side, is equal to, we're gonna take the opposite of x minus 8. I'm gonna start with solving this equation over here on the left-hand side. So in order to solve this one, so if we're solving for x, we need to get our x's together, we need to get our numbers together. So since this is a positive x, I'm going to subtract x on both sides. X minus x cancels. Let's drop down that negative 8 over here. On the left-hand side, 7x minus 1x is 6x, and drop down that plus 12. Now kick that number over to the other side. So this is a positive 12, so subtract 12 on both sides. 12 minus 12 cancels, and 6x is equal to a negative 20 here. All right, so the last thing to do here is to divide out the coefficient. So remember, this is 6 times x, so the opposite of multiplication is division, leaving us with x is equal to, well, let's see, we're going to have to simplify this. On the right-hand side, we had negative 20. We're dividing it by 6. That does not divide out evenly, but you do need to simplify the fraction. So taking a look at a 20 and a 6, let's see, what's the biggest thing that goes into it? Is it a 2? All right, we can divide out a 2 from each one of these, and x is equal to a negative 10 over 3. I know we don't always like to get fractions as our answers, but we do have to deal with them. They will pop up. We can still work with this. But let's pause here for a minute here. Let's move over to the other equation that we're going to solve. So the other equation that we're going to solve, the first thing that you need to do is to take the opposite of that. So we need to distribute this negative over here. So I'm going to drop down the left-hand side for right now. On the right-hand side, a negative times an x makes that a negative x. And negative times negative 8 is now a positive 8. Now solve this equation. So I'm going to move x to the left-hand side. So here I'm going to add x on both sides. Negative x plus x cancels, and we're going to drop down that 8 there. On the left-hand side, 7x plus 1x is 8x, and then drop down that plus 12. Move the 12 over to the other side, so let's do minus 12 on both sides, and that's going to give us 8x is equal to 8 minus 12 gives us a negative 4. Divide out the coefficient, and we're left as x is equal to, well, let's see, a negative over positive, that's going to be negative. So 4 divided by 8, we're going to have a fraction here once again. Don't leave your answer as a decimal. Most of the time, they are going to want a fraction here. We can divide out a 4 from each one of these. So we're going to be left with a negative 1 over 2. So here we have x is equal to negative 10 thirds, and then x is equal to a negative 1 half. So here we are, unfortunately, when it comes to absolute value equations here, we're going to have to plug this into this equation and check it. I'll leave that part up to you, but do keep in mind when it comes to absolute value equations, you do need to take these values here, plug them in for x, and check to make sure that they do work out, right? So otherwise, another thing here is a lot of times they do want you to graph your solutions. So if you were to graph these solutions, so let's say that these two, we check them, they make sense. These are equal then equations here. So x equals a negative 10 thirds, x equals a negative 1 half. All right, so let's see. So we're talking about negatives here, so I'm going to put a 0. Here's a 1, a 2, a 3, and I think that's good enough. A negative 1 half would be between the 0 and the 1, right? A half is about right there. So that's our negative 1 half solution. Negative 10 divided by 3, that's like a negative 3.33333 and so on. So that would be somewhere around here. This is the graph. What the graph would look like here. So these are equals, so they're just dots over here. They equal those two numbers, and that's it.